Right, hello and welcome to the Lake District with Chasing Views. Now, we are at a place called Dodd Wood, which, as you can see from behind, is a lovely area. Now, tonight or today, we're going to be walking up and we're going to be going up for a wild camp on Dodd Fell. Now, it's not a massive climb or anything, more of an enjoyable one. I had planned for originally Skiddaw, then I looked at the weather and I didn't want to chance it. Then I found a little spot called Scale Tarn. Now, that really did look a lovely little spot, but again, we've arrived quite late this afternoon, so I'm really stuck for time. So I've a bit of a last minute decision, and not much time for forward planning, so I thought Dodd Fell would be ideal for a wild camp. So thanks for joining me and off we go. Now, although I've not parked in here, I've been dropped off, there is ample parking. There's a tea rooms, as you can see behind. Although that doesn't open till 10 a.m. on weekdays, or so not really ideal for an early start or an early get up on a wild camp and then having to hang around till 10 o'clock for a breakfast. So I shan't be visiting there. I'll probably end up going into Keswick actually, but as you can see, there's plenty of parking down the back, and you have got behind me again some very clean toilets. Having just used them, I can confirm that they are nice and clean, although the hand dryers need replacing. So Dodd Wood, there are a number of trails, and looking at the map, I shall be taking the Dodd Summit Trail. It's approximately 4 miles and it should take around 3 hours, so hence shorter walk than Lencathra or Skiddaw. Now, you actually, if I remember right, there's a viewing point for ospreys, but I've not really looked into that, but not something that interests me, to be honest. So this is more of a forestry walk, this one, until you get onto the summit, and then we'll be getting some lovely views of Bassenthwaite Lake, which is, I've driven past there lots and lots of times. I did have a little photography afternoon there once, but the weather let me down. So, but as you can see from behind, a very scenic start to the walk, and I'm very much looking forward to it. Now, I did watch a video of Dodd Wood only a few days ago, and it was a chap called the taxi driver. Hello, the taxi driver, if you're watching this. I always like to mention people where I found information and from their videos, and you are, again, you are one of them. So a big thanks to the taxi driver. Check out his channel. So we're going on the Dodd Summit Trail. I'd just like to advise you that it does say no cycling on these trails. So if you are looking at this thinking, Oh, that's a nice little trail for mountain biking. It does actually say no cycling, so please do bear that in mind. Now the weather's great inside this forest. It really guards you from the wind, which is good for when you're videoing a walk. Because my last video, I wild camped up Kinder last Friday, and as soon as I got halfway up, the video footage was rendered useless due to the interference on the mic from the wind, and I was somewhat disappointed. It was a cracking wild camp, and like I say, spoilt by the strong winds. Now, having seen the taxi driver's video, he does mention that some parts of this are very, very steep. Now, there's nothing wrong with that. It's quite nice to do a bit of graft. Makes you feel better when you get to the top, knowing you've done the walk. You get a sense of achievement once you've put some hard work in. Now this forest is a lovely little place, and although I've just said there's no cycling, it does look like a good little track for mountain biking. Although I don't do mountain biking, it does look like a nice little track. Imagine you see quite a lot of wildlife in here at times. It really is a lovely little spot. Now, if you're wondering where this is located, it's Dodd Wood. The entrance is on the A591, which heads to Carlisle from the Keswick area, and it runs parallel with the A66 on the opposite side of Bathenthwaite Lake, which is behind me, and you'll see more of that once we get to the summit. But very easy to get to. I think I saw that the car park was £6 something. Now, I don't begrudge paying, but when they overprice things, I don't know, it probably puts more people off. I mean, I've decided to stop for two nights, but tomorrow night I'm in the travel lodge at Cockermouth, just down the road. I'm a very big fan of Cockermouth, and I've been a regular visitor there for probably the last 12 years. And having seen what they've been through in recent times with the floods, not only once but twice. Oh, look at that. What a find. So we'll hand that in when we get down to the house. So as I say, having seen what they've been through in recent years with regards to the floods, I enjoy coming back and spending my money, because they really do need all the help and support they can get especially independent businesses. Now, I've seen a lot of, over the years, since the floods, I've seen quite a few independent traders on the main street. I've noticed that they've closed and they've not bothered to reopen. Now, insurance costs, etc. There's lots of things that, there's lots of factors why people haven't reopened, but it's sad to see. At times that main street can be a bustling little community, and it's got such a nice feeling to it. Now, we have spoke about moving up there. We live in Nottingham, but we have spoke about moving up here, and it probably will happen one day if I get my wish. But that remains to be seen. I'd like to say hello to Ian and Ruth, because I know they'll be watching. Thumbs up to you. Now I'm just going to take in a bit of scenery. Just arrived at a very scenic and quaint waterfall. I'm assuming that this will eventually run down to either Bath and Thwaite or Bass and Thwaite, or I think it's Derwent Water on the other side of Keswick. Now, Derwent Water on the other side of Keswick, that's also a lovely lake, and it offers some spectacular views. You can go down and catch a boat. There's plenty of places to get coffee, and it's just an awesome place just to chill. Now that's somewhere I would definitely be heading back to, Derwent Water. In fact, I've got an A3 print on my wall from last time I went to visit Derwent Water. Now, I've probably been, since my last video, I've probably been walking, I don't know, 15-20 minutes, and some parts of that are fairly steep, especially carrying a bag. Now, walks up to the summit of fells, hills, mountains, whatever you want to call them, it's never going to be easy because you're going to the top. But I wouldn't call this, even without my bag, I probably wouldn't call it a leisurely walk. As I said, it does get fairly steep in parts, and as you can see, probably see from my forehead, it's my early morning tea is starting to seep out my forehead. Now I'm just thankful that I'm not Harry Hill, otherwise I'd be dripping like this lovely waterfall. I'll probably have 5 minutes here and just admire the view, take a cold drink, and be on my way in 5 minutes, and I'll catch you again near either something worth mentioning or something near the top. See you shortly. Now, I've just arrived at another waterfall, which again I assume will be running down to either Bass and Thwaite or to Derwent Water. But I find the sound of freely running water quite relaxing. It really is a peaceful looking place. Now it's getting the chance to see such beautiful things like this that makes the walk more enjoyable and gives you more of an incentive to want to come back. Now, I've just walked past a sign and it's telling me that the summit trail is actually closed and there's a diversion. But whoever manufactured that sign or designed that sign, it would have been such a simple task and a very good idea to tell visitors that do not know where they are that at what point they are reading that map, and then they can work out which way they've got to go. Now, although I've got my bearings and certain landmarks like the bridge and the clough, I couldn't work out the exact point of where I was on that map, so couldn't redirect myself to wherever you were pointing me to. So if somebody that works for this area actually ends up watching this, that may be a bit of constructive criticism for you to perhaps next time advise people who are reading your signs, advise them at what spot they're actually reading it, and then it will be far easier to navigate to your diversion area. But I'm not in no rush. I've got my tent, I've got my stove, I've got my water, I've got my pot noodle, I've got endless amounts of latte sachets, a warm sleeping bag, my down jacket, lights. I'm here for the night, and hopefully a night without any rain. Now, as you can see behind me, I think, correct me if I'm wrong, I think that is at some point on the way up to Skiddaw. Now, my intention was to go up Skiddaw initially. Things changed. Then I was going to go to Scales Tarn, which looks absolutely awesome. And then, because we were stuck for time, I've ended up going Dodd Fell. No mean feat or anything, but lovely place with lovely views. Now, I'm just starting to get the view of Bassenthwaite Lake behind. I don't know if you can see behind me. That's Bassenthwaite. Now, again, I've come to one of these signs. Green Summit Trail and Forest Road closed to public access at Broad Doors north of Summit Route. To access Dodd Summit, use Southern Loop. We are carrying out road engineering works with large excavators on the Forest Road at Broad Doors. Please stay clear of these operations. Please use the Southern Green Trail Loop to gain access to Dodd Summit. Use the Southern Green Trail Loop to gain access to Dodd Summit. Dodd Summit Trail. Dodd Summit Trail and Forest Road closed. As I've just said, there's no indication of Oh, red squirrel down there. It's the first one. Somebody did advise me that there's quite a few red squirrels in this part at Dodd Wood, and it's not something you see very often these days. You see plenty of grey squirrels, but no red squirrels. But one's just ran across the path down there. Now, I used to see one regular when I've been up to Cockermouth quite a few times on a place called Eitel Road. One used to run across the road there quite regular. In fact, that regular, the locals actually put a sign up on the grass verge, said danger red squirrels, or drive slow red squirrels, which is an indication of just how much people do like red squirrels. There's not many fans of grey squirrels, I can tell you that. But anyway, back to this Dodd Wood. So, we're going up this way. Now that's Bassenthwaite Lake there. Now, we are heading up that way. You can't really see much at the moment. But that's where we're going, up behind me. And I can just see some nice bright skies beaming down onto the green grass over there. So hopefully the cloud may break and make it a bit more enjoyable. Although I don't want the sun to come out just yet, because I've got my basal hair on under this. In fact, I think I had this on last time and it was absolutely roasting. I should have learnt my lesson then, but I've still got the noise of the running water in the background, which is nice. Gives you a sense of nature. Now, I was expecting to see more wildlife, to be honest, but at the moment we're not really seeing anything, and I've not seen many people, to be honest. There's some coming down now. Let's see what these have got to say. Right at the root. Dog. Hello, dog. Hello. This is a steep one. Right. There's quite a few people coming down now, so I shall ask these and catch you shortly. Bye for now. Right, just my luck, the wind is starting to pick up now, and I'm really hoping it doesn't spoil my recording it up on the summit. As I said earlier, my last wild camp was, or the video footage was ruined, specifically by the wind and the microphone interference. But I just stopped for a bit of a drink. That bit was quite steep, certainly with this bag on my back. So I'm just gonna have a quick drink and then head on, soldier on, as they say. And I'm not too sure how far I've got to go now. I know I'm on the right track and I'm sort of more out in the open now, and there's actually blue cloud appearing, so that may be a good sign. So as I say, I'll have this drink and I'll march on and catch you somewhere near the top. And I've just reached the top of that, what felt like a really steep climb. Now you've just got a view there, I don't know if you can see, of Bassenthwaite Lake, which is heading towards Cockermouth Way. Cockermouth is over that area. Absolutely lovely part of the Lake District. You really, really should come and spend your money in Cockermouth. Businesses need you. Now, this isn't the part I'm going up, but beautiful all the same. Now, I'm heading up this direction and I'm hopefully not too far away from the summit now. So, I'll catch you in a moment. Further in the trees because the wind in the open is, now we've come to higher ground, it's far too windy without getting interference, but aren't those views spectacular? That's, those views were heading towards Keswick and Derwent Water with I'm not too sure what the fells are called, but absolutely beautiful. I think one Cat Bells, is it? Now, I've seen some information about that, and that's another one I'd like to camp on. Absolutely stunning views from up there. But as you can probably hear on the mic, the wind's picking up, and there's a strong possibility that I may, when I get my tent pitched, I may have to turn from narrating to some nice chilled out music rather than you listening to wind interference on the mic. But if you look behind me, that's where I'm heading now. I've just stopped for a drink, took my bag off for 2 minutes. Thoroughly enjoyable within these trees, although you don't get the views, but you still get a sense that you're out in the open and enjoyable all the same. As I say, some might call this a leisurely walk, but I certainly don't. Some of the hills are quite steep in parts. And if you're planning on carrying a heavy bag, it can be torture in parts. It does get easier. It does get easier. So anyway, I'm just going to have a drink again. And it might seem that I've only just had a drink on the video, but that was probably about over half an hour ago. And quite a few hefty steps ago, so like I say, I'm gonna have a drink again, do a bit more, and I'll catch you shortly, hopefully with some good views. Now if all of a sudden you get video without any narrating on, then that's due to heavy wind and it's pointless. I mean, I've spoiled the wind spoiled the last wild camp video, so this time I'm not going to let it spoil it. I'll just change the narrating to some nice chilled out music so you can carry on watching, look at the views, etc. See what I get up to. You can even watch me eat my pot noodle if you want. And don't turn off because it's a chicken and mushroom. Now with regards to my Van Gogh bag, There are parts of it which I'm not happy with, and I'll see how it goes on the way down, but I'm considering returning it. Anyway, we'll see how it goes. It's comfortable, don't get me wrong, and I can get my kit in it, but there's certain parts I'm still on the fence with, but I'll let you know more when after I've got down to the bottom. So now I'm gonna have a drink and I'll catch you in a bit. Bye for now. Now I've just come across this. This is something I've not seen before. It's something to do. It says grey squirrel control. Now I'm assuming this is some kind of mechanism that stops grey squirrels getting in. I don't know. Can you answer that question? Can red squirrels get in and grey squirrels can't? I cannot see why. But I'd like an answer to that. Can anybody answer that? Please do answer that in the comments box. I'd love to know. Thank you. Probably far too windy for you to hear me, but I shall give it a go anyway. As I said earlier, that's doing water. The view at the back, we've just got the sun lighting up the top of the fells. Looks absolutely awesome. Now the wind's far too heavy again, so I'm going to stop narrating and just have a walk around and put you some nice music on. Hope you enjoy it. Thank you. Right. Oh, so much for pitching on Dodd Fell. I've been scouting around up there for literally an hour. And you can probably see there is no flat ground whatsoever. Absolutely none. So I'm actually walking back down in the hope that I may just spot some on the way down. Now, you're probably well aware that you shouldn't wild camp anywhere in the Peak District or the Lake District. So it's always nice to be out of view. But even somewhere out of view, I can't find anywhere. It's crazy, all this open space and one flat piece of land to put my tent. Now, some of you might be saying, well, there's a bit there. I can't pitch there. What happens when the walkers come? What happens if somebody from the Forestry Commission or whoever it is appears? I'm absolutely miffed that I can't find any flat ground to pitch a tent that is probably 6 foot in length and 4 foot in width, if that. But I can't. I've had a scout round, I've had a chat to a chap up there who I couldn't believe it actually. The bloke was stood there in a t-shirt and his wife rang while I was up there and he said, oh hello love, yeah, I'm just off up Skiddaw to get some pictures of the sunset. I can assure you, my friend, these dark clouds are not going to offer any sunset at all. But he's a regular walker up these parts and he said you'll be lucky to find any flat ground. But I've not found any videos where people have camped up Dodd Wood, to be fair. But if anybody who's looking at this has camped up there, I'd be very interested in knowing the spot where you camped, because it's just, I can't find anywhere. It's crazy. But anyway, I'm on my way down and we'll take it from there. See you shortly. Right, having mooched about for another hour and a half, I cannot find anywhere to pitch my tent. I've decided to call this a wild walk instead of a wild camp. I won't call it a failure because this is a place I've never visited before, so I did get to go up to Dodd Fell, but a bit disappointed. But it's just hard to believe that there's nowhere to put a tent in such a vast area. So I'm heading on back down now, and hopefully, just hopefully, I can get a lift back into Cockermouth to the travel lodge. Now, we booked in for two nights anyway, so getting a room isn't an issue. The room was already booked, but as I say, I'm a bit disappointed. I wanted to be waking up to some lovely views rather than some travel lodge wallpaper. That's not saying your wallpaper isn't nice, travel lodge, but a beautiful view is my preference. But anyway, I'm just going to have a little mooch about again and see what I can see. I've just spent 10 minutes at the bridge, had a drink and just stared at the running water again. Lovely, it's absolutely lovely. I had a chat to a few people, hello if you're watching, and so I shall see you when I get back down to the gate. Now I'm assuming the calf will now be closed. I could do with a bit of a brew, to be honest, but hey ho. So if you've watched thus far, my apologies that you're not going to get the wild camping experience, but I hope you enjoyed the walk and the nonsense I've been spouting. I'll most certainly make the next one to flat ground. There's nothing better than sitting there on the top of a fell or a mountain or a hill in your tent, peace and quiet, with your gas on, boiling yourself a brew and looking forward to waking up to some lovely views. Now people, I suppose, wild camp for different reasons. I've seen some people that go wild camping and they don't really take any photos. But I think it's the photography that got me interested in such an activity, I suppose. Although I love the camping aspect of it. Chasing lovely views, hence the name chasingviews.co.uk. Where it all stemmed from. But anyway, if you think you've got a different angle of view, you're actually on my lightweight tripod for taking still videos. So you might be closer, higher, lower, etc. But anyway, I'm just going to head on back down, get to the gate, and see you soon. Bye for now. Right, so I'm back down at the main entrance to Dodd Wood, which is just off the A591, and I'm sat outside the old sawmill tea room. Unfortunately, sorry, we are closed is displayed, but not a problem. I'm just waiting for my lift back to the travel lodge in Cockermouth. The toilets are open, so I'm assuming they're open all night. Not sure, but I'm sorry it's not been as exciting as it was planned, but you can't win them all, as you probably are well aware. Although there was no camping involved, it's been a thoroughly enjoyable walk and great views, absolutely great views. Now it's very calm in the wood, but as soon as you get in the open, the wind picks up and the audio just disappears, as you obviously seen. But thanks for watching anyway. I hope you like what I put together. I've put a video together with very limited footage, to be honest. I hope you enjoyed it all the same. Now I surely deserve a like, just for the fact that I couldn't find any flat ground to camp on. Come on. Anyway, Don't forget to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. And why not visit chasingviews.co.uk, where you can have a look at some of the content from other wild camps, photography trips, walks, etc. I will be updating that on a regular basis, whether it's photographs, content from a walk, or content from a wild camp. All comments are welcome. Criticism is as long as it's constructive criticism. And once again, thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit that thumbs up and subscribe. Bye for now.